Namaste, this is Chandrasekhar Phansi from Mumbai. As you know, I am a sitarist and also a Surbhar artist. This is the Surbhar what I am performing for you this evening. This is also known as a bass sitar, bar sitar, lower sitar. Because the scale of sitar is C sharp or D. Here it is G or G sharp, meaning sitar scale kali 1 ya safed 2 hota hai, ye kali 5 ya kali 4. This is your sa. It looks like sitar with different tumbha inside curve and width is more. The frets are thicker. String, the first string of sitar is 030 gauge. This is 050 gauge. In practice, it is known as 3 number and Surbhar is 5 number. This evening, I am going to perform for you Raga Shri, which is a Sandhi Prakash Rag. I will be performing for you Alap and Jod in Raga Shri. Basically, for Surbhar, you need to play only the bowl Da, that upward bowl. This is not there. This is not done in Surbhar. How you do in sitar? Other important factor is there are no tans in Surbhar. Also, it's more played on the parda. It's more played on the mean rather than the parda. Like that. So I will begin my Surbhar recital with Raag Shri, and after a small performance of 20-25 minutes, we will welcome your question answers. Thank you. Here is Raag Shri on Surbhar. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
धन्यवाद. दिस वॉज राग श्री फॉर यू. You should like it. Now let us welcome questions. Thank you.
दोन क्वेश्चन आले. सेम अच्छा. पंडित जी, टेल अस अबाउट द हिस्ट्री एंड बर्थ ऑफ सुरबहार, हाउ इट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम सितार.
कोणाचा क्वेश्चन?
क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम सुविक्षा संतोषी.
The difference between Surbahar, what is that? Difference between the Surbahar.
Tell us about the history and birth of Surbahar and how it is different from Sitar.
In fact, to make it easy to understand, I would put it forward this way, that Veena made easy. Veena made easy is Surbahar, and Surbahar made easy is Sitar. In a very brief one sentence, I have explained you. In fact, Surbahar used to accompany the Dhrupad artists in ancient time, in 13th century. And when the Khayal style came into being, they started accompanying on the sitar. But I will not be able to quote the exact year of the birth of Surbahar, but somewhere maybe around 13th century, during Tansen's age. Thank you.
Second question is also the same. Basic difference between sitar and surbahar.
Basic difference between sitar and surbahar, I already explained when I began my recital. Technically speaking, this is in G or G sharp, safed 5 ya kali 4, and sitar is in kali 1 ya kali 1 ya safed 2, that is C sharp or D. And this is only on the kharaj side. This is the sa. And if you must have noticed that I have not gone beyond this fret. And in the sitar, the whole thing right from, you can pull from here and go further down. Whereas in surbahar only mind works, no tans. So these are the major differences between the sitar and surbahar. Surbahar is only meant for playing the dhrupad and the alap jod. You cannot play the gat. Sitar ka raja khani, masjid khani gat, vilambit gat, dhrud gat, you cannot play on the surbahar. You cannot even play the daga daga de 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 on. Only da, only bol da is there on the surbahar. The thing, strings are thicker. The first string in sitar is 3 numbers, 030 gauge, this is 050 gauge. It is 5 number. Accordingly, all other strings are thicker, so it's hard to play compared to sitar. But it is easier than Veena, definitely. Bolo.
Okay, sir. Dona chalat chalat karan. We'll wait for more questions. Ajun kai mai.
Kalpesh, any other questions? Or shall we go ahead? Or how to go about it now? Kalpesh? Any more questions? Surbahar, about, let me tell you whatever I have gathered about Surbahar. Master Surbahar player had been Ma Annapurna ji, who had been a daughter of late Marhum Ustad Alauddin Khan, who was Pandit Ravishankar's guru. And she played till I suppose from 1940-50, and then we were not able to hear her anymore. For some reason, some recordings are available. Ustad Imrat Khan, the master sitarist, also is a known surbahar player. These are the two masters who had been playing sitar, surbahar, and there are a couple of more. But what I have performed before you is mostly self-taught by listening to the recordings and that. You have to learn authentic surbahar, but that is not possible these days, I suppose so. But Dhrupad singers, what they sing, that is exactly played on the Surbhal. And yeah. with the Surbhal, you don't get tabla. You have to play the pakhavach. When the Dhrupad is played on the Surbhal, or even some artists, even couple of times I have also taken pakhavach when I play the jod, rhythmic alam. But that doesn't support well, and that doesn't give justice to the rag. That is what I was told by my experts. So I have stopped taking the pakhavach.
Yeah, one question from Subhiksha Santoshi. Can you please play three most widely played ragas on Surbhal?
Widely played ragas on Surbhal are alap oriented rags. You will know, you if you are a musically inclined person, you will know that there are two kinds of rags. Dhrupad oriented and alap oriented rags and Thumriyangaki rags. So Thumriyangaki rags are not played on the Surbhal. In the morning rags, Bhairav and all you can play, but not Bhairavi. And afternoon time, all types of Sarang, but not Kafi. And evening time, evening time, Marwa and all. And night, midnight, Malkos, Bageshi, all those. Basically, not the Thumri type rags.
What is the difference between Surbhal and Veena, asked by Prachi Kelkar?
Surbhal and Veena, basically Veena is a South Karnataka instrument. Karnataka rags and Karnataka style is played on the Veena. And Surbhal is typically for Hindustani, authentic Hindustani music, that is Dhrupad style, Dhrupad Angake rag. And Dhrupad style is performed on this Veena. On Veena you will not get to hear Dhrupad, but you will get to hear on the Surbhal, and you will not get to hear Karnataka music on the Surbhal, which you will get to hear on the Veena. In fact, on Sitar also you don't get Karnataka music. Earlier they used to call Veena for any stringed instruments, they used to call Veena. Veena meaning string instrument, and they used to have different kinds of Veena, Naradi Veena, Mayuri Veena, Chitratantri Veena, Saraswati Veena, and so on. So this is a kind of earlier days, this was also, I have not heard Surbhal, for Surbhal anyone has addressed as any kind of Veena, but sometimes Sitar also used to be called as Tritantri Veena, that is what is read, but there are a lot of controversies. Yes, next one.
Next question is asked by Alka Dixit. Are there any Surbhal Gharanas?
There are basically two Gharanas. What I know about that, and those gharanas of Dhrupads, Vanis, that is called Vani. So those different Vanis are gharanas for Surbhal. And here Shriniya Gharana is there, in which Ma Annapurna ji used to play the Surbhal, and Imrat Khan used to play the Surbhal, who was not from Shriniya Gharana, who was from Purab Baj, which is now known as Virat Khani Baj. Yes, next.
Next question is asked by Kalpesh Vedak. Why Surbhal is literally called as springtime of notes?
No, it is not springtime notes or anything. It is not of that kind. Surbhal, why it is called Surbhal? Because maybe Surah ki Bahar, only due to that. And it has a lot of potential. The artist should be capable of handling the Surbhal. If the artist is capable of handling the Surbhal in the most effective manner, then it will be really a Bahar of Suroki Bahar.
Maybe search on Google
and Google Madhi Himanshi. Haan, Google Madhi Asir Ta Sangta Google
Madhi Okay, Suviksha Santoshi is asking, can you please play any one of the ragas you mentioned?
Yes, you name the rag. Yes, you can name the rag. You name the rag, I can play. Consider the time, I will play for you rag Malwa. A brief rag Malwa. For that, I need to change this string. Thank you. नाही पण इथून आवाज येईल आधी राग मागवा पाहू
question is from Sanjeev Shri Krishna Patankar. Surbhar and Sitar practice karne ka tarika same hota hai?
Nahi, bilkul alag. Bilkul alag. Sitar aur Surbhar ka tarika alag hai. Dedication and lagan, ye dono mein hona hi chahiye. But otherwise, technical practice of Surbhar and Sitar are entirely different. Surbhar is only wind oriented, gamak oriented. And sitar, along with that, also taan oriented. Sitar मध्ये taan, taan ची practice पण असते, पलटे वगैरे असतात. त्याच्यामध्ये सगळं काम मींड मध्ये असते. मींड आणि गमक मध्ये.
How many string does Surbhar
have? Same as sitar. Same string, सात तारा, संजीव जी जबे. Same string as you can see, Surbhar and sitar. Only difference is the gay, is the scale. Even tarav string. Yes, pude.
Ata ragaanchi request set hai. This is by Suviksha Santoshi. Please play Raag Todi and Sindhu Bhairavi or any one of your choice.
Sindhu Bhairavi will not be there because it is a Thumiyanga Raag. And Todi, as a music lover, since you have requested, I will fiddle for a while, but it's a morning raag.
All right.
When you heard, if you are a musician, classical musician, practitioner, then you, for you, it's something which I want to share with you. That just you heard Todi, and before that I had played at length Rag Shri. So Shri and Todi are of same Anga. Because there is another Todi called Gurjavi Todi, jo Malwa Anga ka hai, and this Miyaki Todi which I played for you is a Shri Anga. You have to get it explained by your teacher. Thank you.
अजून रागांची फरमाईश है, चारुकेशी और बसंत मुखारी और मुल्तानी.
So there is no point in I can just since you requested I can just show a glimpse, but on Surbaha you have to play the rags in very detail. So this carpenter बसंत मुखारी. Bhairava and Bhairavi, mixture of Bhairava and Bhairavi, blending of Bhairava and Bhairavi is Basant Mukhari. Okay, Kalpesh, Azun Kai. Kalpesh, shall we conclude our recital?
सांगतो इथे.
So, काही नाही आहे, लिमिट नाही आहे. यू कॅन कंटिन्यू इफ यू वॉन्ट.
बट आहे का कंटिन्यू?
आहे, तुम्हाला मेसेज केले सर, जसं म्हणतील तसं.
ओके, फॉर टाइम बिंग विल टेक अ पॉज हियर अँड आपण नंतर परत दिग्दर्शन. नमस्कार, थँक्यू. थँक्यू कल्पेश. अँड थँक्स माय ऑडियन्स.
सॉन्ग एक आहे पण हे सॉन्ग.
नो, यू कॅनॉट प्ले सॉन्ग ऑन द सर्व्हर.
कल्पेश,
चलो, धन्यवाद, नमस्कार.